Hello, my name is Jan.
My name is Alex.
And I'm Henry, and we want to tell you about the benefits hybridization has for plants.
Researchers at the University of Fribourg in Switzerland studied hybridization of poplars, and our group interviewed one of their members, Dr. Celine Caseys, at the Biodiversity Research Center at UBC. She shares her experience with us.
My name is Celine Caseys, so I have a PhD in biology from the University of Fribourg in Switzerland. I did all my PhD working on poplar trees and all the secondary chemistry.
Celine and her colleagues studied white poplar, European aspen, and their hybrid offspring. They collected leaf samples from locations in Italy, Austria, and Hungary. To eliminate the need to keep going back to these locations, the team decided to grow their own trees right at the university.
So what we did was to go mainly in Italy, and we collected seeds from the trees, and we created common gardens closer to the university.
Different extracts were made from the leaves for DNA analysis. This can be easily be done for any species.
Okay. So for example, it's the same system as for example in human, where you can send a little bit of your DNA and they can tell you if you have blue eyes or blonde hair, or if you're native from Europe or from Africa. It's all the same technology, more or less, the same idea.
Celine used genetic tools to find places within the genes that are responsible for the production of chemicals, such as a mass spectrometer or liquid chromatography, and finally, microsatellite analysis. In the end, they produce a genetic mapping of the different genes.
Mass spectrometry sorts ions based on their mass to charge ratio, while liquid chromatography separates a sample into different parts.
So what microsatellites are genetic sequences that repeat itself. So say if we look at the genetic sequence right here of the parent and child, you'll notice that here it's AC, 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 and this will be the microsatellite because it's repeating itself. And what scientists will look for is differences between the microsatellite of the parent and the child. So if this is AC, 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 and in the child it's AC, AC, AG, AC, you'll notice a difference between right here and here. And scientists will take this difference and produce a genetic mapping of all the
differences in the microsatellites.
Conclusively, this research shows the hybrids are able to more efficiently produce chemicals for better protection of themselves.
Add more metabolites, so more defense, chemical defense in the leaves would be less or more attacked by these different categories of insects.
This could mean possibly lessening the need of pesticides if this is utilized properly, or open doors to other interesting applications such as farming. It reduces the cost of growing crops for farmers and poses less health risk.